Last time we had started talking about the notion of strong connectivity in case of directed graphs. So here is a question for you. It's actually a small application of depth first search as well as breadth first search in case of directed graphs. You are given a directed graph and you want to determine if this graph is strongly connected. How do you go about doing this? See, essentially you want to determine that if you take any pair of nodes in the graph, then will that pair be mutually reachable or no? That's the question you are trying to answer. So one simple way of doing this is the following. Take any node, say U, in the graph and perform DFS on this node. Now when you perform DFS on this node, what will it yield? It will give you all the nodes reachable from S. In fact, instead of DFS, you can also use BFS here, because even BFS performed on this node will give all the nodes reachable from S. That's what you want, right? So you can use either of the two. Yeah, sorry. So the name of the node is U, not S. Either DFS or BFS can be performed on node U to determine the set of all the nodes which are reachable from U. Now what you need to verify here is, if the set of nodes given by this algorithm is actually the set of nodes of the graph. In other words, you are trying to ask if every other node in the graph is reachable from, again, it's not S, it's U. So the question that you are trying to answer is every node in the graph reachable from U? Now, if the answer to this question is no, which means that the set of nodes given by the algorithm, by DFS or BFS, whatever you have done, it does not comprise of all the vertex set, the entire vertex set of the graph. There are some nodes that are missing. Then you can straight away conclude that the graph is not strongly connected. This is obvious, right? So for example, suppose node X was missing from this set of nodes. What does that mean? It means that there is no path in the graph from U to X. There is no such path. And that gives you a pair of nodes U and X which are not mutually reachable. And the existence of one such pair of nodes is sufficient for you to conclude that the graph is not strongly connected. So if this set of nodes that is given by the algorithm, it does not comprise of the entire vertex set of the graph, you can straight away conclude that the given graph is not strongly connected. That's for sure. Now, what if the answer to this question is yes? This simply means that U has a path to every other vertex. U has a path to every other vertex. But does that answer your question completely? In order for the graph to be strongly connected, just observing that every node is reachable from U doesn't suffice. So what you can do here is that you can repeat this procedure for all the vertices in the graph. If there is even one vertex whose DFS tree does not include the entire vertex set of the graph, then you can conclude that the graph is not strongly connected. For example, you started performing DFS maybe on node say V, and you found out that there was some node Y missing from the set of nodes given by DFS. Now this would straight away mean that V and Y, they are not mutually reachable. They are not mutually reachable, and therefore the graph is not strongly connected. But if the DFS performed on every node yields all the nodes in the graph, then what happens? So suppose DFS performed on every single node of the graph yields the entire vertex set of the graph. What would that mean? See, when you performed DFS on U, you concluded that every node is reachable from U. When you performed DFS on V, you again got the entire vertex set V. What do you conclude? You conclude that every node is reachable from V. Similarly, every node is reachable from every vertex of the graph. In other words, every node is reachable from every other node of the graph, and hence any two nodes of the graph are mutually reachable. You arbitrarily pick any two nodes of the graph, say x and y. X should be reachable from y and y should be reachable from x. And since x and y are arbitrary nodes, any two nodes are reachable, mutually reachable. And therefore, the given graph is strongly connected. That's a very simple algorithm. How much time does this algorithm take? How much time would this algorithm take to give you the answer? See, you are running DFS on every single node of the graph. What is the time taken by one call to DFS? That runs in, one call to DFS runs in linear time, which is order m plus n. Okay? And how many calls are you making to DFS? N calls to DFS. And of course, it's a connected graph, rather a strongly connected graph. So the number of edges would be at least as many as the number of nodes. And therefore, the total will be order n into m plus n. But since m is larger than n, m is larger, the graph being connected. Okay? So the total running time therefore turns out to be order n into m. Do you see why? Because here m plus n can be replaced by 2m. M is at least as much as n. Okay, so the running time turns out to be order n into m. Now this is a very, very simple algorithm, but the running time is huge, right? So the question in front of us is, can we do better than this? In fact, let me more precisely say, can you answer this question in linear time? I would like to get an answer in linear time. Linear is m plus n. The algorithm is very, very simple. You start by performing DFS on any given node u, any node u. Pick any node of the graph and perform DFS on that. And as before, you are asking the question, is every other node of the graph reachable from u? If the answer to this question is no, then you straight away conclude, the matter ends. You straight away conclude that the graph is not strongly connected. And if the answer to this question is yes, which means that every other node of the graph is reachable from u, then instead of repeating this DFS procedure on all the nodes of the graph, you do something smarter. You take the reverse of the given graph, take the reverse graph of G. What is the reverse graph of G? It has the same set of vertices, but the edges have their directions reversed. And now on this graph, this newly defined graph, you perform DFS on the same node U. Perform DFS once again on the same node, but in the reverse graph this time. Now once again you ask the same question. Are all the nodes reachable from U in the reverse graph? See, this time this question will be in the context of the reverse graph, because you are performing DFS on the reverse graph. Okay? So once again you ask the same question. Are all the nodes of the graph reachable from U in the reverse graph? Suppose the answer to this question is no. What would that mean? The matter ends. You can straight away conclude that the graph is not strongly connected. Why? Because you would get a pair of nodes which are not mutually reachable. Is that right? So even if the answer to one of these two questions, which two questions? The question that you asked in the context of the original graph, and the question that you asked in the context of the reverse graph, even one of them, even if one of them has answered no, then the graph is not strongly connected. Now suppose that even the answer to this second question is yes. What does that mean? See, this means that all the nodes are reachable from U in the reverse graph, and therefore all the nodes have a path to U in the original graph. How do you get this? Remember the first claim that we had made? We said that we will call this claim 1. What was the claim? A node S is reachable from a node U in the reverse graph if and only if U is reachable from S in the original graph. So, if every node is reachable from U in the reverse graph, then U should be reachable from every node in the original graph. Correct? And therefore, if I arbitrarily pick a node S from the graph, then S and U should be mutually reachable, which means that there should be a path from S to U and there should be a path from U to S as well. And this should be true for every node S in the graph. Alright? So, U is mutually reachable with every other node in the graph. Now, consider any two vertices of the graph. Suppose I pick V1 and V2. Now, the claim that we just made holds for V1 and V2 as well, which means that S and V1 are mutually reachable. And similarly, this is actually U. The claim was about U, right? S was an arbitrary node. So, we take two nodes V1 and V2 and we should be able to conclude that U and V1 are mutually reachable. And similarly, even this should be U. U and V2 should be mutually reachable. Now, recall the second claim that we had made. What was the second claim? In the second claim, we said that if U and V are mutually reachable and V and W are mutually reachable, then U and W should be mutually reachable. That was about transitivity in this reachability relationship. Okay? So, here V1 and U are mutually reachable, U and V2 are mutually reachable. Therefore, by claim 2, V1 and V2 should be mutually reachable. But V1 and V2 are two arbitrary nodes of the graph. And this means that any two nodes of the graph are mutually reachable. And hence, the graph is strongly connected. Is this clear to everybody? Any questions on this? Any doubts? Now, remember in the context of undirected graphs, we used to talk about connected component containing a node S. For any node S, we used to talk about connected component containing the node S. That was in the context of undirected graphs. Now, analogous to this, we have the concept of strong component of a node S in case of directed graphs. Strong component of a node S. Now, the strong component of S is defined as follows. It is the set of all the nodes V such that S and V are mutually reachable. Strong component of S is the set of all the nodes V such that S and V are mutually reachable. So, every node in this strong component would be mutually reachable with S. Now, how would you find the strong component of a given node S? Suppose I give you a graph G and a node S and I ask you to find the strong component of S. How would you do that? Aap node S pe DFS perform kariye, original graph mein. Isse aapko ek set of nodes milega. Let us call it X. And this will be the set of nodes reachable from S. Is that right? Now, you take the reverse graph and perform DFS on the same node S in this reverse graph. Now, this would give you another set X prime. Let us call it X prime. And this will be the set of nodes from which S is reachable. S would be reachable from all these nodes. Of course, S is reachable from all these nodes in the original graph. Is that clear or not? So, X is the set of nodes reachable from S. X prime is the set of nodes from which S is reachable. What will their intersection give me? These will be the nodes which are mutually reachable with S. Okay. So, X intersection X prime would give me the set of nodes which are mutually reachable with S. And therefore, this precisely is the strong component of S. Any questions on this? Now, a very, very important observation. For any two nodes S and T in a directed graph, their strong components are either identical or they are completely disjoint. Recall that we had made a similar statement in the context of undirected graphs also. So, in the case of undirected graphs, what we had said was that the connected components of two nodes are either identical or they are completely disjoint. They cannot have some nodes in the overlapping region. Okay? We are making a similar statement for the directed graphs now. We are saying that if I take two nodes S and T and I look at their strong components, of course, we are talking about a directed graph now. So, if I look at these two strong components, the component of X and the strong component of T, then they will either be completely identical or they will be completely disjoint. Let's try to prove this. First of all, observe that for any two nodes S and T, only one of the two following situations can arise. Either these two are mutually reachable or they are not mutually reachable. There is no third possibility. I have randomly picked two nodes from the graph. They will either be mutually reachable or they will not be mutually reachable. Okay? So, we take two cases. First, suppose that S and T, they are mutually reachable. Suppose they are mutually reachable. This is case 1. And the assumption that we are taking in case 1 is that the two nodes that you have picked, they happen to be mutually reachable. Now, what you want to prove here is that the strong components of S and T, they are identical. That is what we would like to prove. Alright? So, consider a node V in the strong component of S. So, this SC of S. This is a notation that I am using to represent the strong component of S. Okay? Consider a vertex V which belongs to this strong component of S. Now, V belonging to the strong component of S, this essentially means that S and V are mutually reachable. That is why V belongs to the strong component of S. Alright? They have to be mutually reachable. But we also know that S and T are mutually reachable. This is the assumption that we had started with. This corresponds to our case, case 1. So, can we conclude something here? V and T should be mutually reachable. So, by claim 2, V and T should be mutually reachable. Now, this means that every node which belongs to the strong component of S also belongs to the strong component of T. Is that right or no? See, when you say V and T are mutually reachable, it essentially means that V belongs to the strong component of T also. So, what have I proved? I started with an arbitrary vertex in the strong component of S and I have been able to show that this node belongs to the strong component of T. Now, doesn't it mean that the strong component of S is a subset of the strong component of T? This is what it means, right? Can I similarly show that the strong component of T is a subset of strong component of S? Giving exactly similar arguments, you start with an arbitrary node in the strong component of T and then you show that S and this node should be mutually reachable and therefore this node should also belong to the strong component of S. So, giving similar arguments, you would be able to show that strong component of T is a subset of strong component of S. And what do these two statements imply? They imply that the strong component of S is exactly identical to the strong component of T. And this is what you wanted to show. You have shown that these two strong components are completely identical. So, in case the nodes that you started with, the nodes S and T, if they happen to be mutually reachable, then their strong components are completely identical. Now, let's come to the second case, wherein S and T are not mutually reachable. In case they are not mutually reachable, then I would like to show that their strong components are disjoint. We shall prove this by contradiction. Suppose by contradiction that there exists a node U in the intersection of their strong components. So, there is a node U which belongs to the strong component of S as well as the strong component of T. Suppose there is such a node. Now, since this node belongs to the strong component of S, therefore, U and S should be mutually reachable. Is that right? That is why U belongs to the strong component of S. U and S have to be mutually reachable. And if this node U belongs to the strong component of T, then U and T must be mutually reachable. So, let me call this observation 1 and let me call this observation 2. So, what do these two observations 1 and 2 imply? By the second claim, S and T should be mutually reachable. But this is a contradiction to the assumption that we started with. And this means that there cannot be any node U belonging to the intersection of these two strong components. And thus, these components are disjoint. Okay? Any questions on this? Okay, great. So, we shall look at more applications of DFS in the next class. Thank you.